So in last lecture, we start the diesel power plant. Okay, in diesel power plant, we see the some important point with respect to diesel power plant. First of all, in the introduction, we see diesel power plant is a peak load power plant. First thing is the it is called as a peak load power plant. Why it is called as a peak load power plant? Because its starting time is very low. Okay, it can easily start. That is the first point. Second point is, it can be used when your demand is increases. You can use at anywhere. Okay, so means it's because of the advantage of its starting time is low. Okay, it can use anywhere. Okay, it is a movable. So this is the second advantage, and it is run for a short times. Okay, so it helps to fulfill the demand of your power generation capacity. So that's why it's called as a peak load power plant. Second point is, its capacity is nearly about 2 megawatt to 50 megawatt. Okay, so basically we get the idea, means the maximum capacity of diesel power plant, we can establish the plant for 50 megawatt. Okay, now the third and important point with respect to your diesel power plant is that whatever be the prime mover which is required to rotate the generator. Okay, so this is your generator, so this is your shaft. Okay, whatever be the prime mover which is required to rotate the prime mover of the alternator, okay, is used the diesel engine. Okay, means as a prime mover, diesel engine is used, so and produce electrical energy. So such type of plant is called as a diesel power plant. Okay, so this is the concept. Praveen.
Yes, sir.
Just mute. Okay. Then second thing is, means what? As a prime mover, we use a diesel engine to produce an electrical energy. Such plant is called as a diesel power plant. Okay, so this is the definition of diesel power plant. So these are the some important point with respect to your diesel power plant. Okay, in the working, we see different components. First is the your fuel supply system. Okay, so this is your fuel supply system. Then this is your air supply system, that is our air intake system. Okay, this is your exhaust systems, which is used as a silencer. Okay, and this is your lubricating oil pump. Okay, so in lubricating oil pump, lubricating oil tank is used, then filter is used. Okay, after the filtration, the oil cooler is used. Okay, so these are the some process. Okay, now next is the your cooling systems. Okay, in the cooling systems, as you see, this is your cooling systems. Okay, in the cooling systems, we use water as a coolant. Okay, and to transfer the water to maintain the low temperature in the diesel engine. Okay, so these are the some important components. And the last component is, that is the starting systems. In starting systems, we use air compressor. Okay, we use high pressures of compressor to start the diesel power plant. Okay, because initially diesel power plant is not a safe starting power plant. Okay, so this is the way we can explain the different component. What is the different component? Once again, I repeat the concept. First thing is your fuel oil tank. In fuel oil tank, if I explain this, in fuel oil tank, there are two type of tank. First one is the main tank. Okay, first one is the main tank, and in main tank give the oil to the day tank. Okay, means, and after the day tank, it passes through the filter. Okay, because filter reduces the impurity, and the when oil is passes through the filter, it directly connected to the pump. And what is the function of pump? The function of pump, it inject the fuel with high pressure into the diesel engine. Okay, so this is the function of your fuel supply systems. Okay, here diesel as a your fossil fuel. Okay, means what? We use main tank and day tank. Why we use main tank and day tank, because in case of your power demand is increases, so to fulfill the demand, we use a backup power tank, that is your main supply or main tank. Okay, and this is your day tank. So this is the procedure in the fuel oil systems or in a fuel supply systems. Now the next procedure is, this is your air intake systems. Okay, in air intake systems, we extract the air, okay, from the atmosphere, and after the extraction of air from the atmosphere, it passes through the filter. What is the function of filter? Okay, it removes the dust, whatever be the dust present in the air, okay, and it also remove the whatever be the impurity present in the air. Okay, so this is the function of filter. So this air now injected into your diesel engine. Okay, here after that, here we use a compression engine in your diesel engine. Okay, so in diesel engine there are two types of engine. First is the two stroke engine and four stroke engine. Okay, so according to requirement we use two stroke and four stroke engine. Okay, so whenever we inject air and fuel simultaneously, this is your injector. So injector inject the fuel in a such a way that in drop form, so that your air is properly mix up with this fuel. Okay, because we use compression engine to start the diesel power plant. Okay, when air and your fuel, that is diesel engine, is properly mix up, then your diesel engine start. After the starting of diesel engine, it converts the whatever be the diesel energy, which is converted into your mechanical energy. Okay, means here we produce mechanical energy. After the production of mechanical energy, is directly coupled to the your shaft of the generator. Okay, means the shaft of generator is continuously rotated. Okay, because of this diesel engine, and after that this diesel engine, or after that this generator converts this mechanical energy into electrical energy. Okay, so these are the procedure. Okay, means what, we use just diesel engine which is directly converted into electrical energy. Okay, so this is the objective of the diesel power plant. This is the first and highest priority objective of the diesel power plant. Okay, now some of the different components we use, such as a silencer. What is the function of silencer? The function of silencer, because there are many rotating part present in the diesel engine. Okay, so that the noise is very high, so to reduce this noise we use here silencer. Okay, what is the function of silencer? It reduces the noise and it passes the air from the silencer. Okay, so it is help to reduce the noise, and the functions of diesel engine works smoothly. Okay, now the next part is the your cooling systems. Okay, here we use some quantity of waters. Okay, this water is passes through the diesel engine. Okay, just see this flow of water. Okay, here we use surge tank. Okay, by the surge tank we use here pump. Which pump? What is the function of this pump? Surge tank means what? Here we use a cylindrical vessel where water can, you can store the water. Okay, so this water is passes through the pump with high pressures. Okay, which is injected into the cooling tower. Now this heat exchanger is passes through the cooling tower. Here we use different types of cooling tower are used. Whenever you meet the diesel power plant, there we see that there are different types of cooler in this shape. Okay, in the tower shape. Okay, now whenever we passes through this water into the cooling tower, okay, means what, when you passes it it contact with the air. Okay, and it reduce the temperature. What is the functions of this cooling tower? It reduce the temperature of water from high temperature to low temperature. Okay, whenever it passes the water through this cooling tower, its temperature getting low. Okay, again it passes through the cooling water pump into the heat exchanger, and this heat exchanger passes the water through your oil cooler. Okay, sorry, around the oil cooler. Like, okay, and this, whenever the temperature of oil cooler is very high, by using the water we can reduce the temperature of this oil cooler. Okay, again this water is injected to the engine, the diesel engine. Again it passes through the surge tank. Okay, so this is the flow of water. Means it just circulate the water from diesel engine to your heat exchanger, then cooling tower, again then passing through the oil cooler, okay, and again diesel engine. Why? Just to reduce the temperature, okay, of the oil, okay, whatever be the high temperature oil after the, because there is very rotting part is present in the diesel oil, that's why it creates high temperature, okay. So this is the functions of your coolant, that is water. Now the what is the functions of your lubricating oil? Okay, the what, whenever there is a, some frictions or there is some inertia is present in the rotating part, we provide a lubricating oil, okay, for the process of lubrications. So it is a part of the maintenance, okay. Whenever you consider any machines, we provide some maintenance. Why maintenance is required? Because there is some inertia is present, okay. So to for the performing smooth operations, we require lubrications process. Now we start the lubrication process. How can we use the lubrication process? Now we consider this is your lubricating oil tank. This lubricating oil tank injects the oil into this diesel engine. Okay. After the injection of oil, okay, because here there are various rotating part is there. Okay. Here we use oil pocket and passes this oil into that pocket. Okay. Now this oil when passes through each and every part diesel and diesel engine, its temperature is very high. Okay, after its temperature increases, it passes through the your oil cooler. Okay, and this oil cooler, the what is the functions of oil cooler? It reduces the temperature of oil. Okay, how it reduces the temperature of oil? By using this circulating of water. Okay, around the oil cooler continuously water is circulated, so sometimes its temperature of this oil is reduces, okay, because of the water. Okay, so this is the way we can provide lubricating oil systems. Okay, now we see the different components of the your diesel power plant. As we see, the there are different components. First is the your fuel supply systems, air intake systems, exhaust systems, cooling systems and lubricating systems and engine starting systems. Okay, I already give the brief introductions in the layout diagram of diesel power plant. Okay, now we see one by one. That is, first is the fuel supply systems. Okay, in fuel supply systems we see that, so this is your fuel tank. First of all, this is your fuel tank, that is your so this is your fuel tank, main fuel tank. Okay, this fuel tank is passes the diesel through the auxiliary fuel pump. Okay, this auxiliary fuel pump is passes then again through the engine drive fuel pump. Okay, this is your engine drive fuel pump. Again, this engine drive fuel pump is passes through the air control unit or fuel control unit. Why we use fuel control unit? Okay, according to the demand of the diesel power plant, we passes the diesel. Okay, so this is the functions of fuel control unit. Fuel control unit passes the oil as per the requirement of the diesel engine. Okay, whenever it passes through the this pipe, okay, this diesel oil, that then this is your fuel manifold valve. Okay, here we use valve for controlling purpose also. Then this is your nozzle systems. Okay, here we consider here the use of nozzle. It okay, it inject the fuel in the diesel engine in the droplet form. Okay, so it is very easy to mix up with the air. Okay, so this is the objective, this is our objective. Okay, whenever there is a consideration of diesel power plant, we require, that is the diesel drop plus air. Okay, that is the your combustion engine. Okay, and after the combustion engine, we start our diesel power plant. Okay, so this is the way we can start our diesel power plant. Now the next position, the next component is air intake systems. Already I explained this concept. Okay, air intake system is nothing but, as you know that in diesel engine, compression engine is used. So in compression engine, we require air plus that is fuel. Okay. So for the purpose of air, we consider this air intake systems. We take in air from the atmosphere. Okay. And after that extraction of air, it passes through the filter. Okay. What is the function of filter? It just reduces the impurity. Okay. Whatever be the dust present in the air, and it inject into the diesel engine. Okay. So this is the functions of air intake systems. Now the next is exhaust systems. Okay. So this is the, in exhaust systems, we consider the silencer. Okay. So this is your air filter systems. After the injections of air and fuel, after the fuel diesel engine is start. Okay. We passes this air into this exhaust systems by using the silencer. Okay. The functions of silencer is just to remove the noise which is present in the diesel engine. Okay. So this is the only functions of silencer. That's why you see the construction of silencer, or whenever you see the diesel generator, it is completely closed and your silencer is present outside the diesel engine. Okay. So this is the reason your silencer is established in the outside of the diesel generator. Okay. It remove your noise which is present in the diesel engine. This is the only functions of your silencer. Okay. Now the next part is cooling systems. Okay. So cooling is one of the most important part in each and every plant. Okay. Whenever there is plant. Okay. In thermal power plant, we use condenser. Okay. In your nuclear power plant, we also use condenser. Okay. And some coolants. Okay. To maintain the temperature in the nuclear power plant. And in diesel power plant, we also use coolant. Okay. So this is because when the interconversion of energy is performed, when one energy is converted into second energy. Okay. So there is a production of lot of heat is produced. Okay. So this is the region. So to maintain the temperature at low level. Okay. We provide a cooling systems, whatever be the plant is there. Okay. Now we have to understand, first of all, the cooling systems. Why we provide cooling systems? Because we see the, this is your temperature range in the diesel power plant. Okay. So this is very high range. Okay. So this, if this temperature is continuously maintained in the diesel engine, it is very harmful to your power plant. Okay. Now to reduce this engine, we provide the water. Okay. Which passes through the, your diesel engine. Okay. And again, this water, it passes through the, your surge tank, then your heat exchanger. And after heat exchanger, it passes through the, your cooling tower. Okay. So the cooling, what is the function of cooling tower? It reduces the temperature of water. And again, it passes through the diesel engine. So in cooling systems, there are two important parts is there. First is in your cooling tower is perform extremely well function, that is cooling tower. Okay. And this second is your, that is your pump which inject the water with high pressures into the diesel engine. Okay. So these are the two important components in the cooling systems. Okay. Now the next part is your lubricating systems. Okay. So in lubricating systems, as you know that whenever there is a friction is present, okay, or there is any inertia is present in the machines, we provide lubrication systems. Whether it is a machines, any machines, okay, whether it is your any plant, okay, we provide, whether there is, whenever there is any rotating part is there, we provide some lubrications for smooth operations. Okay. Now in the diesel power plant, we use some lubricating oil tank, okay, oil pump and oil cooler. These are the, and plus filter. Okay. Add here one more point, that is, sorry, filter. Okay. So this filter process, now this filter process is used to reduce this impurity present in the oil. Okay. So these are the part of lubricating systems. Whatever, what are the parts? First is the lubricating oil tank. Second is the oil pump, oil cooler and filter. Okay. The purpose of the lubrication system is to reduce the wear of the engine moving parts or to reduce the friction in the engine moving parts. Okay. The next part is the, there are different types of rotating parts like shafts, piston shafts. Okay. So to reduce the frictions of these piston shafts, we provide some lubrications. Okay. It also help as a coolant. Okay. We continuously passes water through the diesel engine, but at the same times lubrication is also provide some cooling to the engine, as we see, because oil is used as a, also a cooling agent in transformer. Also we use a transformer oil as a dielectric medium or cooling medium. Okay, means what? Oil is used as a cooling also in the diesel engine. Okay, so means it is very important functions. It perform two operations. First is the, it can maintain the temperature of the diesel engine, and it enhance the smoothness of diesel engine. Okay, so this is the very important parts with respect to enhance the efficiency of diesel engine. Okay, so this is the function of lubricating systems. Now the next part is the now, everyone, please tell me, what are the advantages? What are the advantages of your diesel power plant? Okay, as we thoroughly see the diesel power plant working, okay, and why it is called the big load power plant. Now, everyone, tell me the advantages of diesel power plant. First, Praveen.
Sir, it can be located at any place. कहाँ भी आप रख सकते हैं वो डीजल का सेट.
It can be located at any place. Okay, this is the one advantage. It is a movable. Okay, then second, Sudhanshu, Gautami, Sanket, Saili, Omkar.
Sir, उसका cost कम है steam power plants और दूसरे भी. और capacity same है almost.
Capacity same है मतलब. Capacity of both power plant, thermal power plant and diesel power plant ki capacity same hai. Is it correct? Sudhanshu. What are the advantages? Okay. I think. Yes, yes,
Efficiency is better than steam power plant.
Efficiency is better than your steam power plant. Okay. Another point?
It requires less quantity of water for cooling.
Yes, yes. This is one of the most important point. It required less quantity of water for the cooling systems. Okay. With respect to your steam power plant and nuclear power plant. Okay. This is the one of the important points. Now, next. Gautami. Hello?
Thermal efficiency is better than steam power plant.
Okay. Efficiency. Is there another point?
Sir, operating इतना staff नहीं लगा दस्त.
Okay, it required less staff. Okay, ठीक है. Again, with respect to starting time, with respect to capacity, we can also talk. This point is also important. Tell me,
it can be started quickly and picks up load in short time.
Yes, yes, this is the most important point. It can start in within a 1 hour, okay, or within a minutes, and it takes peak load at very quickly with respect to your steam power plant and nuclear power plant. Okay, one of the most important advantage of the diesel power plant, it is its starting time is very low. Okay, so what is the advantage? If starting time is low, if my demand is suddenly increased in the power plant, okay, and I required some some electrical energy to fulfill this demand. Okay, then I just set up the diesel power plant to fulfill this demand. Okay, means what? I just consider diesel power, establish the diesel power plant to fulfill the demand of your whatever be the power demand is there. Okay, so this is very important point with respect to diesel power plant. First point is its starting time is very low. Okay, it considered as a peak load power plant. That's why. Second time, water quantity is very required is very less with respect to the steam and diesel power plant. Third is the it is movable. It required less space. Okay, that is the third point. Fourth point is you can easily establish or you can easily manufacture the diesel power plant. Okay, it required less space. Okay. And its maintenance is very low with respect to other power plant. Then fifth point is a staff required. Okay, to operating the diesel power plant is very low because if you once start the diesel power plant, it can automatically generate the electrical energy. There is a no concern or only there is a problem of lubrications. Okay, you have to just maintain the lubrication process in a proper way. Again, we can give the advantage that whenever we require any power production means small amount of power, okay, then we use a diesel power plant, okay, as a stand up power plant, okay, standby power plant. So these are the some advantages with respect to your diesel power plant. First advantage is the design and layout diagram is quite simple. It requires less space, okay, it can located at any place because it is a movable. It can be started quickly and pick up the load in short times. Okay, so these are the most important point with respect to diesel power plant. There are no standby losses. Okay, these are also because its efficiency is very high. It required less quantity of water. It's also important point with respect to a diesel power plant. The overall cost is much less than the steam power plant and with the same capacity. Okay, the thermal efficiency of the plant is higher than that of the your steam power plant. Okay, so these are the some important points with respect to diesel power plant. Okay, now tell me the disadvantage of diesel power plant. Nikhil,
lubrication cost is high, sir.
Lubrication cost is high. Again,
high running cost due to cost of diesel.
Yes, its running cost is very high because of the diesel. Okay, it's very costly. Okay, then
sir, maintenance charges just the
maintenance charges just that. Okay, again with respect to power generation capacity,
small amount.
Yes, Sri Krishna.
Small amount of power.
Yes, we can generate only small amount of power up to 50 megawatt in case of your diesel power plant. Okay, so these are the one of the disadvantage means diesel power plant is only used for low power generation capacity up to 50 megawatt only. Okay, so this is the your second points, second disadvantage. What is the third disadvantage?
Plant does not work efficiently and under continuous load.
Yes, this is the point that your plant is does not work under the consideration that is if you continuously work, okay, for 6 to 7 hours, it not able to take the load for longer time. Okay, so this is the one of the disadvantage of diesel power plant. What is the conclusion? We can't run the diesel power plant for very long time. Okay, so this is the conclusion of diesel power plant. Means it required very less power. Okay, sorry, it required very start for very less time. Okay, so these are the some disadvantages. So in the detail we see first is the plant has a high running cost. Okay, because of the we use that is source fuel is diesel. Okay, that's why its running cost is very high. The plant does not work satisfactory under overload conditions. If there is any overload, okay, it can't survive with the overload for a longer time. Okay, so this is the disadvantage of your diesel power plant. Then third part is the plant can only generate small power. Okay, means your power generation capacity of this plant is very low. Okay, as you see, because this is your peak load power plant, the cost of lubrication is generally high. Okay, whatever be the lubrication is provided to the maintenance of your diesel engine, its cost is very high. The maintenance charges are generally high. So these are the some disadvantages with respect to your diesel power plant. Okay, and as we know that whenever we say this is your peak load power plant, by using this word peak load, okay, you can define the advantages and disadvantages easily. Okay, if you understood the concept of peak load power plant, what is meant by peak load power plant, we can easily write down the advantages, we can easily write down the disadvantages. What is the advantage? It is start within a very, it required very short times to start the power plant. Okay, this is the first point if it is a peak load power plant. And what is the second point? It can generate the, or it can fulfill the demand of peak demand. Okay, whatever be the, if there is any power demand is needed, okay, it can easily provide your peak demand load. Okay, and third point is the requirement of water is very low with respect to steam power plant. Okay, in case of disadvantage, by using this concept peak load power plant, we can define that this is peak load power plant, that's why it's not run for longer time. This is the first point. Okay, and the second point is the, it can survive with the overload conditions. If there is any emergency overload, it can provide for a longer time. Okay, or it can't survive with the overload conditions for longer durations. So these are the some points with respect to peak load power plant. Okay, if you understood the concept, that is peak load and base load, you can write down the advantage and disadvantage of your diesel power plant also, and your nuclear or thermal power plant also. So try to understand the concept of peak load and base load power plant. So in this way, we complete this diesel power plant. Okay, and here